I'm most honored to be here. My name is Gert-Jan van Dommelen. I come from the south of the Netherlands, and that's why I have a soft pronunciation of my hard name. Thank you. I'm a member of Rotary International, and I brought with me a Dopper, because what we try to convince people is refill as much as you can. So although we like the fully recycled bottles, the water in the Netherlands is pure enough to drink as by itself. So when you have finished the bottle, refill it at any tap that you can find in the Netherlands. Yeah, so thank you. We started an initiative as Rotary International last year, June, called the End Plastic Soup Initiative. And the End Plastic Soup Initiative is meant to tackle all Rotarians worldwide. End plastic soup is the plastic waste in our environment. And we all love plastic, and especially as Rotarians, who are we to tell other people how to behave? Or who are we to tell other people to do something about sustainability? Because we mostly do not use our own practice or the things that are wise to do. However, we could have a big impact. And that's also why I'm very proud and honored to be here. I want to invite you, first of all, to become all a Rotary member. And I will explain to you why that's important and also why it's possible and to your benefit. And second is, Rotary is a different organization than it was 106 years ago. Rotary is now an organization, 40% women, still some older people with a lot of connections, a lot of networks, and maybe some money, yeah? But there is a big organization that can be of influence and that is really achieving things. And hopefully we can do the same for plastic, because that's what this idea is about. So we talk about awareness, action, and alliances. I'll try to skip as quickly as possible. And then this should go to next. And where should I point? And I just do next. I can do back. Yeah. Yeah. So maybe you can help me with it. Or I do it by hat.
Can you see? No, it's okay.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Okay.
So the... No, it doesn't work. So the End Plastic Soup Initiative started last year by awarding the Innovation Award of Rotary Europe, which consists of cities, the capital cities of Europe, who assemble already for 73 years, every year in a different city. And last year we had Amsterdam, and the Amsterdam clubs together jointly invited Bojan Slat of the Ocean Cleanup. And this young inventor, Dutch inventor, is well known by most people in the world because he made a system where he's going to clean up the ocean. So he's really sending out his second expedition from Hawaii next, the end of this month, after the first expedition broke. This still doesn't work. We awarded him this Leonardo da Vinci Award for Young Inventor. This guy is really following his passion. And when we realize how big the garbage patches are in the world, then we are really amazed what is going to be done. The biggest garbage patch is between Hawaii and Los Angeles. It's 3 times France. It's 2 times Texas. It's 5 meters deep. And that's the amount of plastic that's floating. The amount of plastic that you can see on the oceans are 5 of those garbage patches. And those don't include the big areas where fishing nets are around, because fishing nets are one of the big problems. And this huge amount of plastic, which is floating there at an enormous speed, is gathering because of currents of waves, etc., in the oceans. This is 6% of the plastic in the oceans. And that's what really struck me. When we decided to go on with this End Plastic Soup Initiative, we thought, well, plastic is more a tool. It's, it's have brought us a lot of hygiene, a lot of nice things, nice products. And now it's going to do another thing, and that's still what I believe. It's going to unite us. Because every human being says plastic is all right, but it shouldn't be in nature. So now we have found something which binds us, which unifies us, and which can help us to really tackle the bigger problems in the world. But now I realize that plastic is a big problem. It's not the problem that we have bottles, etc., and that we try to find new ways of recycling. The problem is already out there in nature. Plankton, which is at the source of our whole food chain, is full of plankton. Plastic. You can photograph it, you can make pictures of it. And when plankton, it hasn't been proven yet, doesn't produce the oxygen, which is over 50% of this planet, then we have a serious problem. And just this Saturday, just last Saturday, the Volkskrant, which is one of the magazines in Holland, produced an article on a microbe, which is a very old microbe thing that exists for 1 billion years on Earth, now is extincting, how do you say that? It's stopping to be there, yeah? It's being threatened with extinction because of plastic. Only this microbe produces 10% of the oxygen on this planet. So we do have a problem, yeah? And that's why I think that... Yeah, thank you. That's why I think that plastic is a tool. It helps us to unite, but it's also something that we should tackle. Not just to stop the tap, but also to clean up and to help awareness for everybody around to do something about this. So it now works. We now have 1,500 Rotarians. This is the name of a guy that, or a girl that's member of Rotary, yeah? From 800 clubs worldwide already supporting us. And Rotary Act clubs are the clubs of people between 18 and 35. We awarded this Leonardo da Vinci Award to Bojan Slat, the young 23-year-old guy now that's cleaning up this all the oceans in the next 30 years. That's his plan, and he's pretty amazing and how it's being done, and we support him in that. 1.2 million Rotarians across the world in 35,000 clubs, they can make a difference, and they will make a difference. And that's what we need to do, because they will tell at least 10 family members, colleagues, they will tell friends, and they will help you and help us all to find solutions and to take action. Because that's also a difference of Rotary. We are named, and that's what we're proud of, people of action. So we don't talk, we just do, and that's what we do. One thing we can all do today is pick up one piece of plastic out of the street or prevent you to buy or to take another bottle, yeah? Refill it. Just one simple action, you can start today. What we also see is to unite us all, we have an increasing speed of action in that way, and we inspire across the generations. What we see is that the young people are understanding that we must change. So we cannot stop, and they will not listen. They will go ahead, so we better embrace them and work together. The same is with countries. We can tell from the Western Europe or from the United States or Canada or Australia how to behave, but in Asia there are different problems. India has very many different problems than we have. And our goals are to have all 1.2 million Rotarians be aware and take action. And we are 1 year ahead. By next year, we will have 3,000 clubs. We just continue in a speed that's incredible. And I think it's also incredible what's then being done. The first Saturday of June is the Rotary and Plastic Soup Day. It's always the start of a big international convention. We had it early this month in Hamburg. Next year it will be between the 6th and the 10th of June in Honolulu. And I think it's a very important part to really tell all the people who are attending there. There are 25,000 participants. And you make an influence. We had big hats of single-use plastic. I have one with me in my car, so I can show you to it. It's a piece of art. And you give attention, because everybody wants to have pictures taken with his hat, you know, with a nice seahorse on it. that taking this this stick that you put in your ear, and it was really nice. Yeah. Also, we want to provide local and global solutions. That's why I like this community, because I think together we can sell these global solutions. We are not there to fight people. We are there to find solutions, and we are there to really help the world come forward. So we have a petition that's signed already by many people. First Saturday in June, we take action. We show ourselves along all the beaches from the top of Norway to Portugal, along all the rivers, and just to take action, to do something about this awareness. Our local actions are in information packages. One is education to children. What do you do? How can you collect? How can you separate? We have event challenges, sport challenges, so that every event will be zero waste. We will not achieve that overnight, but we can reduce from 30% now to 5% by the end of the year, I think by 0% in 2 years' time. It's all about thinking about the beach, the forest, the rivers, the waters, and the cities, because in the end, plastic comes in the ocean, but it starts at the street. It starts with textiles, it starts with what we produce. This was one example in New Year's Dive, so that's me over there. You can enjoy. It was pretty cold, yeah? And we started a school challenge with the children in our hometown. The mayor was there. This is our mayor. He didn't took a swimming clothes, but I think the message is clear. Make awareness that this is a serious problem. So we have local actions across Europe. 46 countries in Europe, which is a big Europe, like including Lebanon and Morocco and Egypt and Kazakhstan and all the Russian states, they joined the action of the Rotaract people. And if you see the pledges that these young people do, I will not, I will stop, I will tell people, it's really great. We have many clubs in Norway that really adopt the bay, and we all say Norway is the most clean country in the world, but what they collect is enormous. And in the end, what we want to do is connect to many, many other organizations. We connect to the Plastic Soup Foundation. Maria is not here because of family circumstances, but we think that they're doing a tremendous good job in really assembling the facts. Is it healthy? What are the problems? What can we do? Where are the problems? But also the Ocean Cleanup organization. They do a lot of collection, but with airplanes flying over, where does the plastic come from? Where should we hit? Because otherwise we are just diving into something. What's the real problem and how can we solve it? And also we work together with the bubble barrier, which is a Dutch invention of a tube on the bottom of a river. Holes in it, you put a compressor on it with just a solar panel. It's very easy stuff on energy-wise. And bubbles appear up and they build up a curtain and all the plastic flows to the side. They have tested in a big river, the IJssel in Holland. They have tested now for microplastics. And 86% of all plastic, but also other waste that somehow is floating, comes to the side. Not just the plastic floating on the top, but also in the middle and even on the bottom. Things that are on the bottom, bottles, etc., because of the bubbles, there's pressure upwards, and it comes to the sides. It's a really great system. You have a tube of 300 meters, costs you $150,000 for 10 years. So we now persuaded President Modi for the River Ganges cleanup to build such a system. Have 20 of those systems, 10 along each other, because the River Ganges is much bigger than our IJssel River. And you clean up the Ganges within months. And I think that we're starting to help on the expedition on the 2nd of October, the birthday of Gandhi, 105th birthday anniversary, with a big expedition with kayaks and boats and it's really to show and give attention to how to clean up the Ganges. And that's important for the youth over there, because everybody in Asia is not trained that plastic and all these things should be gathered and collected and not just being thrown in the water. I have some tremendous pictures, but Murray have seen them, and we've made them in Indonesia, and I think that's where we also need to go for the problem. So, having said that, Hamburg, Aloha Rotary in Honolulu, you're much invited. Find a Rotary member that takes you as a guest, and you can go up there. And we have big organizations within Rotary that take care. They're called Rotary Action Groups, the Water and Sanitary Rotary Action Group, or the Environmental Sustainability Action Group, that really help us to build this awareness. So that brings me to this nice picture of Justin Hoffman that we were allowed to use. I don't know if everybody's seen it, but it's from National Geographic. And it really gives this sensitivity thing to the plastic issue. Yeah, we don't want this. So we said, sign the petition, go to endplasticsoup.org. We are all volunteers. Normally I work for another company. And this is all voluntary work. Take action, and together we can. And that's the message that I want to give to you. Please join us. Become a Rotarian, but help us to tackle this problem together, because that's what we need. Thank you very much.